Leafs have been in the finals 19 times. Canadians are right on their heels with 18 appearances in hockey's Blue Ribbon Classic. And Detroit also has been in the finals 18 times. So these two teams, Dick, have had a lot to do with fashioning many of the thrills that have punctuated the play in Stanley Cup competition over the many exciting years since the NHL started to compete for the Stanley Cup. That was back in 1926. Russo coming out over the line with Duff, Cornwallier, and Richard. Russo, a pass deflected by Hillman. Hillman at his own line. Hit. Russo is picked up by Pulford. He plays it back to Marcel Pronovost, who shoots it down the ice, and now we have 1 minute remaining in the penalty to Papin. Richard is going to lead the attack. A pass to J.C. Trombley on the right wing to Russo. Russo through center ice. Hits the Toronto line to Cornwallier. Cornwallier near the point. Back it goes to J.C. Trombley. He's getting set, going in for the shot. And Sawchuk got the right arm on it. Here's Dick Duff. Back to J.C. Trombley to Russo. Russo to the side of the net. Cornwallier back to Russo. Russo shoots it. Oh, a deflection is grabbed. The loose puck. It's against the man. Richard chopped at it. Pronovost takes it in on the board.
Well, a close call at the left-hand side of that Maple Leaf net. The bouncing puck up against the mesh. First the shot by Russo, and then Richard as he tries to slip it under or over Terry Sawchuk, but he just missed that net. You know, quite a contrast in the goaltending department with Sawchuk tonight appearing in his 93rd Stanley Cup playoff game. Seemed to have been injured just a little bit on that last exchange. And you know, Danny, Terry Sawchuk's first Stanley Cup playoff game was a bit of a history maker, March 27, 1951. It went into the fourth overtime period at the Detroit Olympia. Quite a spot for a rookie in his first playoff game. And at that point, Rocket Richard decided that enough was enough, and he scored at 1:09 of the fourth overtime period. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal.
No fuss about info on Expo from Esso, because Esso is with you all the way.
Sawchuk is at the Leaf bench, talking to Punch Imlek. He's going back in, I think. Sawchuk, he's battered and bruised, but he keeps his head high, and he's standing tall in every sense of the word in the playoffs this year. The great veteran from Winnipeg, Aaron Sawchuk. In playoff competition, Sawchuk with 11 shutouts. He's number two in that shutout parade. Just ahead of him, Turk Broda with 13. 26 seconds left in the penalty. Now it's Cornwallier working the side, trying to get in front of Beliveau. Shot, a screen shot. And it was blocked by defenseman Tim Horton.
Cornwallier-Beliveau combination, very dangerous on the Canadian power plays tonight. Nice sort of smooth play by Cornwallier there. Gets it out to Beliveau, but Horton drops to his knees to make it.
By Ellis and almost into his own net. Here's Russo shooting it. It bounces. Cornwallier scores!
By Cornwallier at that left post. Watch him. He gets it and pulls it back just in the nick of time to slip it into the short side. His second power play goal of the night, and the Canadians take a 3-1 lead.
And
you know, Danny, you mentioned Vachon's great save off Gordie Howe in his opener, and you know that famous quote of his when they said, what did you do against Gordie Howe? And he said, oh, was that Gordie Howe?
From the face-off, that one would have been wide, but Vachon kicked it out. Now here's Mahovic getting set to center it. It goes off J.C. Trombley. Armstrong in the corner, playing it back to the point of Vaughn. Vaughn winds up, and the shot hit Harris. Vaughn again, a backhand shot. It's high, and J.C. Trombley in the corner. Back it comes on the right wing, Provo to Beliveau. Down with Gilles Trombley. Beliveau is shooting it in. Trombley against Armstrong. And it's Vaughn coming up with it for the Maple Leafs. Vaughn with Beliveau trying to tie him up. Vaughn comes up with it again out to Keon. Back it goes to Mahovlich. Mahovlich over the line. And he was checked by Provo with the result that his shot went away wide. Into the corner. Bouncing in there is Keon. Keon playing it on the boards against Beliveau. And they've been doing a lot of jostling tonight. Nothing serious, just looking for possession. Here's Hillman trying to golf it. He missed it. Mahovlich swinging in from the right wing boards. Trying to feed it in front. And Beliveau lost it to Armstrong. Back it comes to Hillman, the shot. Armstrong has to go off his stick. Ted Harris ahead to Provo. Provo down on the right side against Cronenvall. The shot was wide. In there goes Ferguson. Provo at the point. A pass stopped by Keon. Keon coming out, tied up by Backstrom. Provo to Ferguson. Ferguson going in against Hillman. And Cronenvall takes over for Toronto out to Mahovlich. Mahovlich winds up for the shot. And it's off the glass. Going to be a penalty here. Harper for elbowing, I would imagine, against Mahovlich.
This game is following in the pattern from a penalty standpoint. The same lines as the second game, Danny, we saw here, the Ranger-Canadiens series with Bill Friday working that Saturday afternoon game. Friday is calling them very, very close tonight.
12 minutes, 41 seconds. Canadian penalty, Terry Harper, 2 minutes for elbowing. The time, 12:41.
During our second intermission tonight, Dan Kelly and Jacques Plante will again be along to discuss tonight's game. And Frank Selke will be chatting with a fellow who's had a lot to do with that 4-1 score, Jean Beliveau. Our Centennial Canada film series will feature the province of Ontario.
Montreal 4, Toronto 1, Cornwallier with 2, Richard and Beliveau, each with a goal, and Hillman scoring for Toronto. It was 2-1 at the end of the first period. Now we have Stemkowski. Horton is playing up on the right side. Pulford on the left wing. Hillman and Papin playing back. It goes to Papin to the left point to Hillman. Hillman shoots it in. Knocked down by J.C. Tremblay. Hillman over to Papin. To Horton. He centered it in front. And Pulford just failed to come up with it. Horton getting it back to Papin. In on the boards. It goes to Horton again. Back to Papin. He scores! Beautiful goal! Great passing between Papin and Horton.
That's right, Danny, as the Maple Leafs had fine puck control on this play. Laferriere gets it momentarily, but he's squeezed out of the play. Back it goes to the point. Papin moves in, and he drills that low to the stick side. That's the place they say to shoot them. So the Maple Leafs now narrow the gap, and it's 4-2. And
Bill Barilko, who scored that dramatic goal in overtime, was that here or in Toronto?
No, that was in Toronto, Danny, in the fifth game, and the Leafs had tied the score with less than a minute to go to force the game into the overtime period.
From the faceoff, it's right on Sawchuk. Keon cutting from in front of the net. Feeds it. Armstrong finally gets it on the right wing. Back to Keon, breaking in on that right side, trying to get by Harper. A backhand shot. And Keon, a great play, but had too sharp an angle. Here's Beliveau taking a shot off the stick of Mahovlich. Beliveau again feeds it ahead. And it's Keon turning for Toronto. Drops it off to Bond. Bond down on the left wing at center. Stopped momentarily by Gilles Tremblay. It's cleared into the corner. And Laferriere with 13 seconds remaining. Laferriere to Gilles Tremblay. Out it comes. Mahovlich back at his own line. Swinging away from Provo. Has to go back against Gilles Tremblay. Now gets it to Stanley. It's cleared ahead. And the siren goes to end the second period. And in that period, Cornwallier and Beliveau for Montreal, Papin for Toronto,